There's no right time, right or wrong time to start. So long as you know that you're into it, you know what you're doing, and you wanna get what is something that you deserve, just go for it.
Good day, viewers. Welcome to the TLG Alumni Project segment. My name is Mika of TLG The Linkages Group. Today, we have Ms. Pearl Joy Tamayo, a nurse who completed her bridging program and acquired her nursing registration in Australian College of Nursing last 2019. She is now enjoying her permanent residency status in Australia and is currently based in Canberra.
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon from Australia.
Wow. Kamusta, Nurse Pearl?
I'm all good. Entering the autumn weather here, it's kind of cold, but nonetheless, all good.
Thank you for sharing your time with us today, and it's good to know that you're doing well. We know that, of course, Education Linkages has been, you've been part of Education Linkages, and we got to know you before, but our audience or viewers would like to know you more. So can you please tell us about yourself?
All right. First of all, thank you for this rare opportunity, giving me a chance to share my life here in Australia and the pathway I went through. Thank you, Educational Linkages, again, for this invite to share a bit and pieces of my life here. I'm Pearl Joy Tamayo. My friends used to call me Pearl for short. And I used to live in Makati City, Philippines. And yeah, I'm a nurse by profession. I'm third child of four siblings. Currently, I'm a registered nurse here in Canberra Hospital, and I'm an ambitious and well-driven person, and I'm passionate about work, life, and in general. Back then, I used to work in private and public hospitals in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. Well, as you all know, as for my profession, serving humanity was mm-hmm. the ultimate goal. So, yes, I was given the chance to work in both private and public sectors or settings back then. And as a nurse way back home, it was really a great, great experience molding me to what I am now. Mm-hmm. And of course, I'm so thankful for the people and patients who I get to work with along the way.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how long did you work as a nurse in the Philippines before you moved to Australia?
I think almost 5 to 6 years.
Oh, 5 to 6 years.
Not okay. Long enough.
Okay, yeah. But how was your life as a nurse before you moved to Australia back then?
My life before and as of now is kind of the same. It's just that the setting itself, maybe. And then, of course, nowadays, the culture is totally different, knowing that the people I'm working with, the first language is English. Mm-hmm. So... though I have many Filipino co-workers as well here, and I'm enjoying every bit of it. Life is work-life balance, should I say. And the only difference is that I'm away from my family, but the thought itself, as if they're with me, thank you to social media, I can be with them, a phone or video call away. But nonetheless, should I say, tolerable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's good to know. And of course, we know that pandemic has been declared since last year. So were you able to visit your family before the pandemic has begun?
Yeah, I believe so. I went to Sydney for schooling or for the bridging program last 2018. And then luckily, I was able to go back home for November up until the holidays. So mm-hmm. I was able to celebrate New Year and Christmas. And yeah, visited mm-hmm. some friends. And then I was thinking, it will be my last na, so I should maximize my time. So after that one, I went back to Australia. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sabak na.
Mm-hmm. Yes, in short.
Yeah, sabak na. Okay. So mm-hmm. yeah, how did you find out about Education Linkages before?
Ah, yes. Way back in the Philippines, I was working as a nurse already. And then one of my friends, I think she's an alumnus as well. She was saying, try mo dun sa agency ko. And ganyan. So I was like, paano? Mm-hmm. And that time, ang layo. I was residing in Makati City and then siya, Quezon City. So I was like, and then yung office niyo is QC. So I was like, ah, andayo. Then when I learned New York Cubao, eh, I'm like that person na pupunta sa malayo. And then, alam mo yun, parang sa isip ko, ang layo. It will take me too far or something. Mm-hmm. Kaya lang, sabi ko, sige, I'll give it a chance. A try. And then after that one, I just asked them what are the requirements needed. Mm-hmm. Slowly, I'm completing the requirements. Next thing I knew, I'm on it. So I was like, it took me some time, but the thought of it, completing all the requirements, documents, papers, and everything, pag inisip mo, tedious siya. Kasi you have to, punta sa ganito sa PRC for your licenses. You have to prepare your passport, make sure it's not expired or something. Mm-hmm. But the bottom line is, you were able to complete those documents one day at a time, but all good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yung documentation, yung processing talaga ng mga documents, we have to undergo tedious processes on that. And it's good that you were able to find us at Education Linkages.
Thank you.
Started your journey. So, plano mo na talaga noon before na mag-Australia?
Yes, actually, when I was in Makati Med, that's the hospital, the first hospital I work with, I was like, paano ako pupunta na Australia? Sorry ko, parang, hindi ko alam kung paano. Kasi that time, I was eyeing USA sana. But then, there was recession, something like that. So on my end, wala na. Mahirap to. Mm-hmm. Sabi kasi, okay, I have to resort into something. So luckily, one of my barkada in college, she told me, I'm going to Sydney na. And then I was like, really? So, paano? So, ako, tamad. Sa mind ko lang. And then, later part ko na-pursue yung dreams ko. So, I was like, sige, try ko na lang. Baka it will make a change. So, luckily, when Jenny told me about EduLinkages or Educational Linkages, I was like, sige, I'll give it a try. And then, when I went there, okay naman, reliable yung mga tao. And then, even though I'm working in Makati and then your place is in QC, they were like, sending me emails, messaging me. So, information, a thing or two really means a lot. Kasi parang kahit malayo, it makes things easier for me. And at the same time, an email away, you can send your documents right away. So, I was like, okay, it will be fine. So, luckily, things went smoothly. Not that easy, pero it came to a point na mabilis na lang siya. So, yeah, all good.
Mm-hmm. When you started, naging mabilis na lang.
Yes, next thing I knew, kailangan ng English exam. So I was like, sige, take ko to, ganyan-ganyan. Pero syempre, through faith and then prayers mo, diba? You cannot do naman anything all by yourself lang. So
yeah,
I just made sure lang na whenever I do something, I pray, make sure na it will happen. So yun. So more or less, not na lang puro drawing para mag-make it to reality, ganon.
Okay, yeah, but what caught your interest to work with us? What caught your interest to travel from Makati to Quezon City and start doing your application?
Kasi I was thinking, if now I will not move on or if I will not make myself available to finish those things, I will end up working in the same place. And at the same time, as we all know, nurses nowadays it's not only for the Philippines. I mean, I'm not saying na hindi maganda work sa Philippines. Kaya lang yung thought lang na yung profession namin, it entails na mag-work abroad. Kasi finances wise, alam naman natin how much nurses nowadays earn in the Philippines, and hindi siya nagko-compensate. Mm-hmm. And experiences per se, you want to, learn new knowledge and to explore yourself. Ano pa yung mo offering ng profession sa'yo? And it doesn't stop and end there. So maraming opportunity waiting. It's for you to find out and to learn for yourself. How will you get it for yourself as well?
Mm-hmm. Well said. Yeah. So talagang yung when it comes to your profession, it has been in demand to other countries. Talagang they give value to what nursing profession is. And you mentioned that you were targeting US as well. So how did you weigh? Paano mo winay yung two countries na yon, yung US and yung Australia?
Actually, I did some research, and then it so happened my cousin din ako nag-work doon, and then some friends already working na doon. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, iniisip ko yung work-life balance. I'm not saying iba yung US, iba yung Australia, but then at the end of the day, iniisip ko, I'll go na lang for Australia. Kasi that time, I realized na yung mga naririnig ko na mga, what do you call this, yung way of living, ganyan. And at the same time,
na curious ako dun sa ano eh, sa tagline na work-life balance. Mm-hmm. I don't know what I'm trying to I don't know what I'm into unless nandun ako. When I went here, nagbago lahat. Though hindi pa ako nakapunta sa US, kaya lang when I learned na ganito pala sa Australia, ganyan work-life balance, I thought na parang sige, I'll give it a try. Though I have nothing against US naman or anything. Mm-hmm. Pero when upon learning na okay yung ganito sa Australia, I did, you know, I did go for it and at the same time pursue kung ano yung gusto ko talaga.
So you're saying that you took the risk kasi you have your relatives in the US, but you still chose to go to Australia.
Yeah.
Mm. Wala kang relatives sa Australia, di ba?
Wala, friends lang.
Okay, wow. So yeah, you took the risk on doing that and it was worth it.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ano ba yung naging motivation mo in coming to Australia? Aside of from your advancement of your nursing profession.
Of course, family ko. And at the same time, syempre, doon ka na end up lang na doon ka lang sa isang posisyon or isang lugar. Siguro parang eagerness to learn what Australia can offer for me and what I can offer in return. Because as a person, syempre, you don't wanna be stagnant lang na, ah, dito lang ako sa isang lugar na to kasi dito ako comfortable. Unless you learn kung ano yung masishare mo or mai-impart mo, might as well go for it. Kanon.
Yeah.
Syempre, given na doon na gusto mong financially, gusto mong, we're not a well-off, I didn't came from a well-off family. Middle class kami. Hindi ganun kayaman, hindi ganun kahirap. Pero at the end of the day, you just wanna endure kung ano yung binigay sa'yo ng parents mo. You just wanna give back sa family mo as a whole. Kanon.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's right. Getting out of your comfort zone is very important. It's indeed important.
I know. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
After completing your EPIC in November 2018, you told me earlier that you went back to the Philippines. So it took you some time to go back to Australia. And what took you so long to go back? And what preparations did you make before your trip back?
I made sure na yung mga documents ko sa Australia is with me na, or I did apply online, like for example, in registration of license and everything. So in mind, I was thinking, kailangan, syempre may goal setting ka na, kasi your visa is only good for a year. So syempre may plan B, plan A and everything. So sabi ko, sige, I'll give it a try, mag-apply ako online. Luckily, yung friend ko from Sydney, she sent me a list of hospitals, because here in Australia, you have to apply online up yung mga regional and everything. Lahat in-applyan ko. And then, when I did my bridging program as well, that time, I was given the opportunity to work in a nursing home and then in a hospital. So, luckily, may mga Filipinos doon. So, they were saying, they were giving me some inputs na how to apply, what do I need to prepare, and something like that. So, I was like, okay. So, parang good pointers yun for me. So, I did try my best. Syempre, I kept the idea of thinking lang na, sige, I'll do what they said. I will comply. But the thing is, hindi ako permanent resident. Yan yung pinaka number one qualification. So sabi ko, hala, ano ba to? Paano? So syempre, wala akong relative. A friend of mine, a college barkada ko, was living in Melbourne. So she was saying, might as well go here, take your luck, blah, blah, blah. So sabi ko, sige, pero I have in mind, pag wala na, mag-student visa na ako. So I spoke to my mom, I told her, syempre, yung mga plans ko, I was telling yung family ko din, kasi para in the end, I know what to do next. So she was saying, sige, plan din mo yung student visa. So sabi ko, dumating dun sa point na yung friend ko, nurse din siya sa Melbourne, in a day, would you imagine, 10 hospitals yung a-applyan ko online, hindi ako mag-give up niyan. Tapos paghapon, I'll check my email. Oh, did somebody, ano ba? Email me. No, reject daw. So, syempre, sa ko, ha, ano ba yan? I'm having, ano na? Syempre, wala na yung hopes mo, di ba? Tapos, pero, paplato yan kapag nag-apply ka ulit. Kasi, alam mo yun? Tapos, yun?
They were responsive.
Responsive silang mag-deny.
Mag-reject.
Okay. Pero, syempre, ako sabi ka, hindi ako titigil. Mm-hmm. So, I came in Melbourne, I think 2019, second week. And then, what I did was, syempre, sige, apply. Then, third week of June, I received this email na saying, we need your phone interview, blah, blah, blah. Sabi ko, sige, I'll give it a try. Kasi in-interview ako nung manager in, so Canberra Hospital na siya. Tapos, luckily pa, ang galing, in-interview niya ako, wala siyang result after a week. So I was like, sabi ng friend ko, hala, ano nangyari sa mo? Ganyan, sabi niya. And then they send me an email, same secretary ng manager. She was saying, and the mo, sabi nung, very English yon, sabi niya, they need you to come in Canberra, sabi niya. Kasi iba daw pagka ano, face-to-face interview. Mm-hmm. What? Only to find out, as lucky enough, kaya lang pala niya ako gusto makita kasi I passed the interview.
Hard na.
Hard wow. na ako. And then, I was like, sorry ko, sorry ko, parang thankful ako in a way. So sabi lang niya, oh, I just want to see you in person. But then the thing is, you passed the exam, you passed the interview. And that time, the phone interview was so tedious kasi mga ICU questions, some medical related siya. Tapos parang sabi ko, sige, sabi ko, I'll take the risk lang of coming, only to find out. He just introduced me to the hospital itself, orient me in anything. And then, a few days later, he wants me to come back na to Canberra. Kasi he wants me na to, I think 3 or 4 days after, kailangan na ako mag-reside kasi I'm for work na. So I got the job, and then after that one, I settled myself, and then, yeah, good start na for me. So everything happens lang na. Not too fast, pero nakakatuwa lang siya in a span of, should I say, a month and 2 weeks
of applying yung
application. Mm-hmm. Then my friends were telling me, ha, how did you get a job? Ganyan. Kasi that time, they won't accept you kasi wala kang permanent resident. Mm-hmm. So luckily, mabait yung manager ko. So yeah, he accepted me and got the job offer. Then history na. That's it.
Yeah, talagang nagbunga yung 10 applications per day. Sa dami ba naman, no?
I should say, yeah.
Yeah, so while you were on a tourist visa, so, yeah, we know that you were only allowed to stay for a total of 90 days sa Australia, right? So, and you were trying to look for work during that time. So, yung transition mo from the tourist visa to working visa was really smooth. But, but yung journey mo before that, do you consider that one as the most challenging phase that you had to encounter?
Of course. Kasi living abroad all by yourself, given na nandun yung mga friends ko, at the end of the day, it's different. Kasi you're on your own, you're self-sufficient, you have to make decisions right away, and those decisions will entail you to decide right away. Mm-hmm, like, for example, when they told me lang na, you need to come here na, you're for face-to-face interview, I didn't have second thoughts. Because all along, I was thinking, I need a job as early as possible. Kasi you don't want to go here lang naman na, alam mo yun, maglaro or something. You want to make use kung ano yung pinunta mo. And at the same time, on my head, every minute, every day, every second really count. So I want to make use out of what I have, out of how many resources I have. And luckily, mababait yung mga friends ko that they told me lang, they guide me through naman. So at the end of the day, so thankful pa din na I was able to endure those hardships and yet succeeded in some ways.
Yeah, so you really had good support system.
Yeah, thankful for that.
Yeah. Now, fast forward to the first quarter of 2020, that was last year, Australia declared a pandemic. And how did the pandemic affect you, your nursing career, and your application, your pathway to permanent residency?
Actually, not only pandemic itself, because before that, scary yung earliest part ng, should I say, end of 2019 and then early of 2020, because that year, bushfire happened. So it was so scary na, you know, I think worldwide, yung news na it came to a point na parang yung Canberra, parang lagi may fireworks ng New Year, so smoky, and then yung eyes mo lagi masakit kasi nga yung smoke. And then before pandemic happens, we used to wear masks na kasi in the hospital, the smoke is everywhere. And then it's so scary to the point na when I leave the house for work, I have to bring my passport with me kasi I may never know if my house will burn na in a minute or two kasi sobrang scary talaga yung bushfire. And really, so scary na super init niya. Tapos, alam mo yung feeling na may fireworks na. Tapos after ng fireworks, smoky yung surroundings mo. And then even yung highway, sobrang dark nila. So you can't drive nicely kasi you have to protect yourself na hindi mabangga yung sasakyan mo, hindi ka rin mabangga. Yung mga ganun. After nung bushfire, nag-hello si pandemic. So, 3 months after, nag-pandemic na. And then, it was so scary kasi syempre, as a healthcare worker, be really obliged to serve humanity, do your job, not only do your job, but at the end of the day, you have to make sure na the people you're dealing with or you're caring, hindi lang sila gumaling, but at the same time, ma-prevent mo yung infection na hindi ma-impart sa isa, and especially sa sarili mo. So that time, of course, it was so scary kasi syempre, I'm all by myself. My parents, my family kept checking out on me. Again, thank you to social media. They can just message or make a vid call away. And then, that time, syempre, dahil naka, yung contract ko, hindi siya permanent. Sabi ko, hala, parang ito, pagkatapos ng pandemic, I have to apply to another state siguro, ganyan. But then, I'm not yet permanent. So luckily, that time, malaki yung massive yung need ng healthcare worker nila. So my manager told me, your contract will be extended. So it's another blessing na naman. So I was like, ah, oh, wow. Before ako mabigyan ng permanent offer, permanent residency nga. So I did apply, get the papers ready, apply online, blah, blah, blah. Luckily, I was able to receive the permanent residency offer already. And then the hospital offered me the permanent contract. So somehow, the pandemic itself and the bushfire itself, both a blessing and at the same time, scary ones. So parang, if you look at it, parang sana hindi na nangyari, sana should have avoided it. But then, siguro may something lang na, ano mo yun, may blessing pa rin beyond those incidents or should I say, scary part of the year. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's
so
right.
Nonetheless, all of us, syempre, a bit scared, but, you know, we have to ensure na lang and at the same time, make it a point na maging healthy ka and kasurpass mo pa rin. Mm-hmm. And yeah. Apparently, nandito pa rin siya. But syempre, yung saddest part pa rin, most of us living abroad, especially with the family living in the Philippines, we can't go home yet. So, yun yung pinaka-hardest part. But, you know, sabi nga nila, safety muna ng everyone before everything. So,
that's right.
Yeah.
As a frontliner, parang extra challenge din for you guys is, of course, to protect yourselves while protecting other people. So
yeah.
Okay. So may vaccine ka na ba? Have you received your vaccination?
Yeah, I have already. AstraZeneca last third week of March. I didn't have the hesitation when I learned about, kasi dito they call it booking. Everything is always a call away, an email away. So on my end, I just called COVID something here, and then I told them I want to book. So when I learned na pwede, I call right away and then book, and then they will not tell you, you cannot choose which one because that time Pfizer and AstraZeneca nga. So ayun, AstraZeneca nabigay sa akin, okay naman.
Okay naman.
I can't wait for the second dose kasi nowadays kailangan ng herd immunity. So yun.
That's right. And hopefully with the vaccines that that are rolling out now, you can soon be with your family.
Go yeah, everyone. Family, right? Yeah, everyone's dream nowadays, walking in the aisle inside a plane.
Yeah, that's right. We all miss traveling. Yeah, and talagang if you're going to your home country, iba yung feeling.
I know. Right? Yeah.
By the way, congratulations on your permanent job in Canberra Hospital. How is your life looking now in Australia?
How is it? Right now, I'm happy in a sense that, as I've told you earlier, it's a work-life balance. I'm a self-sufficient person here. I do my own thing, do the laundry, do the cleaning and everything. So I live my life one day at a time. So I always go to work with a happy heart and happy mind. So, syempre, no to negativity. Kasi syempre, yung mga news, pandemic,
masyado nang negative.
Yeah, you don't want to end up choosing those things for yourself na. So, yeah. So, at times when I just at home lang, listen ka lang ng podcast, ganyan, something na mag-boost ng moral mo, ng energy mo, na even though you go to work na alam mong busy, you'll end up, you know, sabi nga nila, ang ganda ka naman pagpasok and then after yung hair mo, they say, wala lang, no to negativity lang. Kasi as the years go by, I know naman in the end na mag-end lahat ng negativity. So yun, everything here in Australia is so good. Every people you meet nowadays are so courteous. Kasi so far, dito lang ako nagstay ng matagal sa Canberra. I like it here kasi polite yung mga tao. And as I said before, in Canberra, when the pandemic happened last year, it took us only, I think, 7 or 8 months na totally yung practicing ng, I know, I think, 4 or 5
protocols.
Oo, yung protocols. Still complying, pero kasi hindi siya yung populated na, ano, populated ng place.
That's good, that's good. And, what part of your job do you enjoy the most then?
Many things. Yun nga, yung sabi ko na yung stress-free living. What I like the most is yung government. They really support the people. Like for example, when the bushfire happened, the government will let you know kung anong dapat mong gawin. So there's a certain number you will call in case there's a fire or something. And then for the bushfire itself, yung air yung problem, diba? So they supply the mask right away. Hindi lang siya yung basta-basta ng mask. So I know for a fact you're safe. And then what else? About Australia, the way of life is so simple. Siyempre, when you go to the grocery, laging 50% off yung mabibili mong commodities.
Wow.
Sana all, diba? Sana mabibili mo sa Philippines. Yun. Tapos, ano pa ba? Yun. When it comes to commodities, really supported ka in a way kasi yung mga fresh na pwede mong, yung mga edible, yun nga, yung mga perishable, edible, things like that, is really of a good cost. So, making yourself healthy in a way is not that easy. I mean, it's that easy, but it's really up to you how to live a good and well-maintained life. Pero yun nga, as a whole, okay siya. Saka, ang maganda, the daylight saving time ended, so it's only 2 hours away, 2 hours only from Manila or Asia. And then when you go home naman, 8 hours plane ride lang. So, and then the weather itself is not that bad, so tolerable siya.
I see. So, yeah, with what's currently happening in pandemic and from the bushfire to pandemic, you really needed yung support. Yeah, from your government, and of course as health care workers during the pandemic, it is good that you were indeed prioritized, diba?
Yeah, and I'm really really thankful for that because since day one, you know what you're up to, and at the same time hindi ka pinabayaan. So how I wish talaga na ganun din yung government sa Philippines, na parang ano yun, especially the healthcare worker nowadays, kasi you may never know kung anong
struggling talaga.
Sobra.
Yung work-life balance, diba, as you mentioned, talagang nandun with your current job. Yeah. And, yung support system also from your colleagues. We all need that during this hard times. Yeah. Now, can you share us your long-term goals? And what do you see yourself doing 5 years from now?
Long-term goal, syempre, ano, I'll do some retirement savings. Kasi dito, okay naman siya. You can support yourself, blah, blah, blah. But then, syempre, you want to see yourself retiring in a way na pleasing sa'yo. Ganon. Tapos, syempre, purchasing a home. As of now, I'm not sure though if I want to stay here for good in Canberra. I'll resort to some places, maybe. I can't say pa naman, but looking forward, hopefully, diba, 5 years from now, traveling will be good and will be fine for everyone.
All right. So now, lastly, can you share your message to those who are to those professionals who are aspiring to seek guidance in moving to Australia?
Siguro yun na lang. Kanta yun eh, ng Semisonic. Siguro yung ano, every new beginning comes from some other beginnings, and there's no right time, right or wrong time to start. So long as you know that you're into it, you know what you're doing, and you wanna get what is something that you deserve, just go for it. Kasi there's no right age, right time, right place. If you know for a fact na you're into it, just go. Kasi people, as I've said earlier, I'm ambitious and well driven talaga in different aspects of life. I'm 38 and I'm not shy to say about my age. But at the end of the day, if you know that there's something in store for you, you'll never know unless you go for it. So just go na lang and, you know, reach for your dreams. Everyone's entitled to their own dreams naman. That's it.
That's right. Take the risks. Go for it.
Yeah. You'll never know unless you go for it.
Yeah, that's right. You'll never know kung hindi ka nag-fly to Australia and took the risk and looking for jobs, right?
Yeah, you have many options to manage. It's really up to you if you want that kind of life, that kind of living. And just go for it na lang and then weigh for yourself. Weigh if it's good for you or not. Then you choose thereafter.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you so much. Very well said. That's very inspiring, Nurse Pearl. Thank you very much for taking the time to share your story with us today. It was a pleasure to speak with you. So on behalf of the Education Linkages team, we wish you all the best. And Education Linkages, improving lives by creating possibilities. This is Nika. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more stories.